are everything. Something real as it could ever be. You gave me all of yourself, I gave you all of me. Now set it free from yourself.
Again, and welcome back to St. Thomas Football's Monday Morning Quarterback. This weekend, our team moved to 6-0 and claimed sole possession first place in the MIAC with a 17-0 win over Augsburg at their place. It was a fantastic game from the start. Defense came out and started strong and finished even stronger. Really happy with the shutout. First one of the season, and anytime you can hold a team that's that potent to a low yardage total and 0 points. Very happy about it. Led by Chinny OG. Can't say enough about Chinny. Once again, he had a stat line that was impeccable with 8 tackles from the corner spot, 2 pass breakups, and an interception. But even more than that, just did a fantastic job on the edge, being put in some positions where he had to take the receiver on and in a man type of coverage, and came up and big for us, including the biggest play of the game, which was an interception in the fourth quarter to seal it. Inside linebacker Tony Dan and Willie Barigi each had 8 tackles, and still just really getting better each week. And Kyle Maroney got his first start of the season, and both he and Harry Patera added 5 tackles apiece. D-line, as usual, we rotated 7 guys in. And one guy who's just been a force for us in there and doesn't get mentioned often is Blake Bricks. He had 4 tackles the other day, but more so just great motor, great effort, and not just rushing the passer, but stopping the run game and playing like a senior should play in our system. We did have a few runs that popped. They had a really nice run game, and a running back who is a very, very capable and talented freshman who was tough to bring down. So they were able to pop some runs and have some success from 20 to 20. But once our defense got their backs to the wall inside the red zone, they really tightened up and came away with some big-time plays. Fortunately, we only had to have our defense on the field 56 plays. It was the shortest game we played all year long with only 152 total plays. And that's fine by us, because that's really how this team is built, to withstand those types of short games when the opposition tries to shrink the game. But our offense was able to be on the field for 76 plays, so having them on the field for 20 less plays, I think, is probably a tribute to our defense's ability to stop the run and also our offense's ability to run the football. We did rush for a little over 300 yards, 330 plus yards, led by the 10-yard-plus average of Dakota Tracy, who had a really nice day running the football, 124 yards on 12 carries, including a 50-yard touchdown as well. But very dynamic running the ball. Certainly not his best day throwing the ball, as he only went 12 for 21. But the run game was also bolstered by Aaron Terrell Byrd, a freshman who was really coming on strong. He had 6 carries for 53 yards. Tough, tough yards at the end of the game. Great blocking on the perimeter. Once again, Logan Marks, Ben Graham, and the rest of the tight end crew doing a good job. And also starting to see the emergence of some of our young offensive linemen really starting to blossom into somewhat veteran players. They're certainly still freshmen, but they're really coming along at this point. Fritz Waldvogel had several catches for 130 yards and made some big-time catches for us, caught a hook route, and ended up going about 60 yards for a touchdown, which sparked us early. But as I said earlier, the ability to run the ball, and they allowed us to run the ball with the way they were playing us, is what made us feel the most comfortable to be able to move it that way. The special teams, it was kind of a nondescript day, just because there were only 11 reps of special teams, which is by far the least we've ever had. Now, they were able to pin Augsburg's offense fairly deep. Our defense was able to start with an average starting field position of Augsburg on their 22-yard line with a long field in front of them. So when they did get the opportunities, both in the kickoff game, Timmy Albert did a good job. We did have one punt, and Garrett Maloney absolutely tilted the field. We swapped punts and picked up about 20 yards on his 55-yard punt. So very happy to see that. But Willie Hersman coming on strong. Not only is he doing a fantastic job on kickoff, but he's also doing an amazing job on punt return, being manned up on a defender out there and being asked to block a guy in a lot of space, and is been doing a good job all year, but had a bang-up game this last week. Players of the game on defense, Chinny Oji. On offense, Logan Marks. On special teams, Willie Hersman. Defensive scout, Cole Kelly. Offensive scout, DJ Hiller. And hustler of the week, Ben Duncan. It's now homecoming week, and we hope to see you all out en masse, wearing purple loud and proud next week at 110 as we take on Hamlin at O'Shaughnessy Stadium. Have a great week.
On the corner, Cretan Summit, stalwart, true and free. There's a team with pride and passion called the University. Hail the Tommies, hail the Tommies, hearts and hands, hail the pie.